you see, I'm eating a protein bar, so I have energy to run over lunch. Hey, we're chopping barley, and it is going to be perfect stuff. Barley is barley that we're taking off at about 60% moisture, and it'll be high energy feed, and we're hoping to get about 10-12 ton per acre.
So today we're taking off our barley. We're gonna direct cut this barley. That means that we're taking it off a little bit earlier than you would if you're taking it off for grain, and we're gonna chop it. So we take this off in what they call a doe stage. The heads are fully developed, but they're not dried down like you would for grains. Getting the bagger all set up. We're gonna run another one more full-length bag on this side, and then we'll see where we're at, if we need to make another one or not. Kind of running out of space on this ag bag pad, but I think we can find a little space yet, so. Ready to get started. So when we direct cut, we're using the same type of chopper that we used for the triticale earlier, but we have a different head on the chopper. So when we took off the triticale, you saw we mowed it and laid it out in a windrow, and then the chopper had a pickup head that just picked it up off the ground. In this case, the reason we call it direct cut is because we're cutting it for the first time as it's going into the chopper. So the chopper is cutting it directly into the chopper. The chopper has a disc bind type head, so it cuts off the grain, the whole stalk and all, and chops all that product and blows it in the wagon. When we just start into the field, so we don't run down any of the crop, the wagons follow the chopper, and we shoot the product over top of the tractor and into the wagon that's following behind. Once we get going and there's enough opened up that the tractor can drive aside, then we don't need to do that anymore. Thank you. Waiting on the chopper here. I thought I'd come out and show you guys the corn. Look at this, it's already popping up through the ground. This is the last that we planted down here. And the first stuff we planted is already getting pretty big. All right, so we just finished up the first bag and we're putting the first load in the second bag here. Looks like that first field gave about 22 tons of the acre. So that's really great. That's a lot of stuff. Out here in the field now, we're just waiting for the chopper. The chopper is sharpening its knives. So this chopper does that all by itself. So you just start the sequence and it does it and it sharpens its own knives. Looks like it should be done pretty soon. So then we'll be back rolling again. So that's it. All of our winter forages are in the bag. Literally, in the bag. Thanks for watching. So we came in the barn here, and this one heifer stuck her head through the gate and pulled the gate off the hinges, and now the gate's stuck on her head. I'm not sure what to do here.
It's Memorial Day weekend, and so this is our tradition of always coming out on the river with some friends that have a little cabin off the river. So it's like, I think 70 some degrees, the sun is in and out. So I'm in a sweatshirt because it's a little chilly when the boat's going. But it's a nice day. But here's to boating season 2022. It's Memorial Day weekend and we're out in the boat and we decided to do some double tubing. Yay!
Is it okay?
No, it's really squishy. It's like squishy. It's like.
And then come. We'll have to put some air in it.
Yeah, put the air in it.
Jaren and I are in the Mach 2. This is a really bouncy one.
That's why it's called the Mach 2.
And well, it was coming off and they were like.
Thanks for watching!